great, great way to start the year. You just can't go wrong with Johann Sebastian Bach, or as I fondly recall him, Johnny Batch, some days. We've got actually a lot of Bach or Bach influences tonight. The Chamber Orchestra has a piece by Bach. The Wind Ensemble has a very long work. If you're sticking around for the second concert tonight, that's about a fugue in D minor by Sebastian Bach. And of course, the cadet strings have a fugue in the style of Bach. So we've got a lot of Bach here in store. For our next one, we're going to have these folks try to find the feeling of the music. And you know, we talk about in tune, in time, in tone, with the fourth element, the fourth T. I love alliterations, by the way. The fourth T in music that we search for is in touch. And to have a folks, you know, a group of young musicians to dig deeper into themselves and to be able to express themselves and be in touch with the music beyond just playing the little black dots that move by very quickly. It's, you know, a lifelong pursuit to find, be in touch. I think all of us have hopefully at some point been touched by music and been transcended, taken away to another place that you weren't thinking about the notes, you weren't thinking about the musicians. It was the music itself that speaks. And you know, the expression, where words fail, music speaks. Where the notes, you know, cease to be in front of you, and all of a sudden you as a musician can just let go. That's where we know we're doing something right. So this group actually performed this last piece, or both pieces, in Moscow, the University of Idaho Symphonic, Strings Fest. We were the only middle school group, and we are not all middle school. We have, you know, some ninth graders, and we have middle schoolers in the chamber orchestra. But it was good for us to be the youngest group, but also to hold our head high and feel like we're doing something right here. And this next one, we've taken it farther. And there's three ensembles, of course, tonight, and one of me. So I was bouncing between rooms, and I walked in, and they were playing as they were moving, they were dancing. So it's nice to have them not need me, I guess, and hopefully to feel the dance that this is. This is a waltz in several movements. It ends with Dark Eyes. We hope you enjoy Czar's Evening.
Thank you.
just asking my tech crew if the live stream was working, and sometimes I don't know if the tech is going to work. The tech, you know, has been a great addition, and you know, I love lights, and it's nice to be able to hear the roots. But yeah, sometimes that's the thing that it's always the button that you didn't press or the connection that's you know, a little finicky. And I always tell these folks, failure is a good teacher. Probably about 2 minutes before we came out, well, failure is a good teacher. We'll do our best, and we'll talk about it afterwards. For me, my failure last week was drilling through that wall and you know, trying to run a cable. I accidentally nicked the lighting cable. So today I was frantically trying to fix that. Failure was a good teacher for me. And more importantly, it's all in the pursuit of making these folks look and sound their best. And so we'll get everything dialed in. Of course, our next big performance with this group, Symphonic Strings, other than we have the NIC gathering the band, or the district, sorry, the district large group, will be also at NIC for From Bach to Rock. And it's always nice when we go there because we don't have to set up our chairs, we don't have to, you know, do our own tech. We show up and they have a wonderful crew there to work behind the scenes so that these folks can enjoy the experience. And we usually save some of our best for last. We've got some surprises in store. So this next group is our first year, or our cadet group. They just, many of them started this process, or some of them did a play last year in fifth grade strings. But we are graduated to full orchestra pieces, and this time they've got more music in front of them. And so it's always been a challenge to do just a little bit more. And we're gonna play two full songs for you, one of which, we're gonna do Elegy and Dance. Just make sure they know what we're doing. Of course, the Elegy, somber, reverent movement, and that goes right into the dance as well. So with these folks too, again, the in touch has been the word for the month, because it's very easy to think, well, I'm playing my notes, I'm done, I got it right. And that's the beginning of the process. And then it's a lifetime of working to find what's not on the page, and the tone and the expression. So we hope you enjoy our cadet strings and two pieces, Elegy and Dance, followed by the miniature.
Thank you.
I feel fortunate in this job to not just have these students. I mean, it's a class, yes, but it's a program, and it's a calling. And so for some of these folks that just performed, our sixth grade crew, we hope that you stick around. We hope you get your belt. The yellow belt is next, and we'll go to symphonics trainings, and that becomes a new training ground. And clearly, they're spreading their wings since half of the symphonics trainings last year was in cadet strings, and now they're playing grade level 3 and 4 Bach pieces and waltzes. And of course, then we graduate to this group. And so some of these students on stage I've had for, this is our 7th year, and to have that kind of longevity and relationship with our students, to see them grow from the little string children all the way to functional adults, really, it's a true blessing. And so we really hope you continue to stick with us. This is not about the performance or the grade. Hopefully it's about having a lifetime of music, whether you're a performer or a lifetime of enjoying music. It's truly a gift, and we're glad these folks have stuck with it. So we're gonna let them warm up for just a second, and then we're gonna play our 3 pieces. As the program says, I am maybe speaking to the folks that are streaming at home. We are doing a live stream. Skylar and our tech crew got all the nuts and the bolts and the buttons. So we're streaming live to YouTube/CDA Charter Music. So if you go to YouTube and you type in /CDA Charter Music, you'll see our page, and you should see this video up right now or right after the concert. So again, we'll let them warm up and tune, and we'll be right back with some more Johann Sebastian Bach.
Thank you.
protect our Grayson. Can you turn down the lights? I think we're blinding them. So just if you turn down the front lights a little bit. I'd like them to see their music, ideally. I was going to say something. Oh, yeah, so you may remember that from October. We performed that first in October, and sometimes, you know, it's a race to the finish line, and we get it on stage, and I think for them, this piece became a challenge. Can we practice not till we get it right, but till we can't get it wrong? And we've been continuing that, finding ways to not just learn our part, but to learn each other's parts, and to be able to sort of forget about the counting and all the technical things that go on, and try to really understand the complexity and the genius of Bach in that fugue. For us to strive for 100% accuracy, as a musician, that's what we have to do. You know, in music, I should say, in normal classes, the normal ones, not the abnormal, a 90% is great, that's an A minus. I think many of these students would settle for an A minus on their test tomorrow. You guys have test tomorrow, one of you? A minus is great, right? That means, you know, only 1 out of 10 mistakes, but for us, 90% is not great at all. That's 1 out of every 10 notes being wrong, or 1 out of every 10 rhythms. And there's hundreds and hundreds of notes sometimes. So for us to, as an ensemble and as a musician, strive for perfection. Be okay that we're never gonna get there, right? We do a performance and we figure out what worked and what didn't, but to continue chipping away at that ultimate goal, where when the music is flawless, then all of a sudden, that deeper connection can be there, and then muscle memory can be there, and hopefully they can enjoy the experience. Because I remember coming after the first concert in October, and it was like they got in a fight or something with the music, so they barely survived. And I don't think they enjoyed the piece as much. And I hope that they enjoyed it more this time around. And we're gonna play it one more time here before we put this piece to bed, and that's on March 19th, where we'll go play it for other high schools in the area and some judges, and they'll sit there and see how close to that perfect did we get. This next one is not about perfect. This is for us about putting this out here in a relatively short amount of time. Like, we started this on Monday, realistically, and for us to take a piece like this that really is challenging in a different way, musically, you're gonna hear, this is not Bach. This is something very, very modern, it's French by Michel Legrand, but more importantly, it's got a much deeper meaning. So we hope you enjoy first rendition, but not our last of You Must Believe in Spring.
Thank you.
I always like to collaborate, to put these folks together. Sometimes that's a logistical conundrum, and we do rehearse this, but we cram in here on this somewhat small stage. We're kind of outgrowing the stage, so. This next piece, we collectively, or I should say separately, have learned when we went down to the University of Idaho Strings Fest, every ensemble played this, and it was the common piece. It was great for us to hear everybody's renditions and how different schools would take different tempos or different dynamics, different interpretations. And we decided to do something a little bit different with ours. And we put a drum beat, and we thought we'd make it a little bit more gospel-y. This is a very powerful hymn that every voice can sing. And we hope to bring you some inspiration as we send you off to your evening. And I'm going to bang the drums back there. Thank you. dismiss these folks, and there's going to be a change over here with the band. You're welcome to stick around, but we are going to ask, kind of make your way to the door, get some fresh air, and we'll be back in about a half an hour or less. And don't forget to take these kids out for ice cream. I think they've earned that, yeah? It's a good night for ice cream. Thank you, guys.
Yeah. friendship for the band and orchestra. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.
jazz combo. Number one. Okay, so next combo two. We have many levels of players here, all the way from our sixth graders, hello, to our seniors, our juniors who have been around for a little while. And when you're in the jazz band, sometimes you're in it for a few years. Some of those folks have been in now for 5 years, I believe Henry, Nolan as well. So we have established a culture where some of our elders are mentoring or coaching, and I gave them that task, and they ran with it. And of course, learning how to improvise when all of the changes and all of the melodies, you know, are very, you can't just play one note. You have to find your pathway through that. So we appreciate those folks. We're going to bring out our first year combo in a little bit. They're going to play a tune for you. These are our first year jazzers, Freddie Freeler. But before we do, I want to, let's turn off the lights there, Caitlin, thank you very much. And we're going to get the concert band up here, but before we do, I want to introduce your conductor here tonight, because at about 11 o'clock this morning, I found out that our first trumpet player just got braces, and that's not exactly great for a trumpet player. So the closest trumpet sub we could find was me, but then the question is, well, who's going to do my job? And at lunchtime, I found this guy. He said, I'll do it. So we're going to welcome to the stage in his debut conducting. And we just had our first rehearsal backstage. It went swimmingly. So please welcome to the stage here, Mr. Mason Curry. So I'm really proud of these students, not just musically, but they're such great people. And when things happen, when life hands you lemons, you make lemonade, you problem solve, and that's the nature of our rehearsal. It's my instrument is out of tune, or we took that tempo too fast. What all the musical things, but I think that's hopefully one of the lessons we're learning here is that you do your best, you prepare, but you also over prepare and learn everybody else's parts and sometimes learn how to conduct. You never know when you're going to be a conductor. Mason woke up this morning not knowing he was going to conduct, and now he's a conductor. So we're very thankful for that, and more importantly, the versatility of the concert band as they have a different trumpet player and, of course, a different conductor in front of us. So this group here is our first year players, our cadet band, and it's hard to believe that many of the folks in the concert band were in this group last year, but that's what we train them to not just figure out which end to blow in, spoiler alert, it's the small end, but also to take themselves seriously enough to want to be good, to want to strive for that perfection, and to want to practice till you can't get it wrong. We hope that they're enjoying this, and we enjoy the things we're good at. So that's my little message, my plea to parents, that sometimes we have to make them practice, sometimes we have to have that structured habit, that 20 minutes a day or 30 minutes every other day, so that way they can get past this frustration. Nobody likes sounding bad. Nobody likes that sort of failure. But if you push through it, there's a whole lot of success waiting for them on the other side of it. So we're gonna ask the first year combo. I did ask for them to come up with a name, and they didn't. So we're just gonna call them the first year jazzers. But most of these folks are in this ensemble for the first time. So they are learning the art of jazz, how to swing, how to articulate, and how to take on the thousands upon thousands of jazz standards, the Great American Songbook, and to learn how to play the melodies, but also how to orchestrate and make an arrangement out of it, and how to, of course, improvise on top of it. And as a trumpet player and an improviser myself, the more I do it, the better I get, and the more I enjoy it, too. So. This is some of them. This is their debut or their second debut, or they haven't been doing this long. So we want to cheer them on. If you hear a solo after they're done, go ahead and clap, and that might just be the thing that keeps them going for their lifetime. So this is Freddie Freeloader and our first year combo, and this is Mr. Ethan Madrid, who actually is going to the University of North Texas for a jazz. Yeah, that's right. This is great. University of North Texas, which is one of the premier music schools in the country. We've had some former students go there, and he'll continue that trial by fire, and he'll go there and get a life lesson in guitar and jazz and music, and hopefully he'll bring back those lessons and share them with us when we see him. So take it away, Jazz Combo 1. Thank you. please welcome to the stage the Cadet Band under the direction of Carrington Reinhardt. Thank you. So I'll put in a plug for our clubs, our one-on-one tutoring that we offer. Many of our high schoolers have been volunteering usually once a week. Sometimes there's things going on. The high schoolers are very busy, but we have our clarinet club, our percussion club, low brass club. Some of these have been going strong. Some of them, we have to kind of nudge and poke and prod, but to have that one-on-one time with problem solving as a band director, as a thousand different problems all at once. And so to be able to have not only that one-on-one time, but also the mentorship with somebody that's been there, they've done that, and they can lead by example. It's a great opportunity for our high schoolers to teach and to hopefully make those connections. And at some point, many of these cadet band folks are gonna be sitting right alongside their high school counterparts, their elders. And then they in turn will pay that forward and pass that along. That institutional knowledge is valuable. And I think as a musician myself, I probably learned more from the people sitting next to me than I did from my teachers. That's nothing. Not to say that we don't have very valuable lessons, but you know, I think being able to work with partners, and it's a team sport, and you know, to have that sort of, I might be good at something that my neighbor needs help with, and they might be good at something that I'm struggling with. So that's really the nature of this ensemble, a jazz band. We've been problem solvers, and our problem solving is this next piece, because Mr. Harrison gave it to them last Thursday. You've seen all those little black dots. There's no new ones. And all those rhythms, yep, that the cadet band technically knows all those rhythms. And so for them to be able to take this tune in roughly, I would say, 45 minutes of rehearsal over the last week has been our pursuit. And it's easy for the loud people in the front to problem solve them for them and to tell them what to fix, but for them to take ownership of the process has been, I think, a valuable teaching tool. Our last few performances, we've actually taken the same piece and continue to dig deeper. And you know, one of the tunes, Cottontail, I think we worked on that for about 4 months, and it just started to get good. And this one, it's like 4 days. So, you know, 4 months, 4 days. But we are gonna feature a couple soloists here, Mr. Ethan Madrid on the guitar, and Mr. Nolan Euler, both of which are seniors, on the trombone. And so this is a tune by Sammy Nesigo, written for a professional big band. This is not your average high school music. And it's our jazz ensemble. It's called A Minor Affair. That's not the piece, that's our warm up. That's what you hear at about 7:03 every morning. All right, you guys ready? Thank you. have time to change our ties. You know what? It doesn't matter what tie they're wearing. I think we'll red or white, it'll be fine. We're going to get the wind ensemble on stage. I'm going to give them a few minutes to warm up, tune, maybe problem solve before we start. And we've got three great songs for you. David Mislenka's Illumination, a Bach Toccata in Fugue in D minor, and of course, last but not least, we're going to feature our guest conductor here as well, Mr. Henry Depew, on Pilatus, a Mountain of Dragons. That's all I'm going to say. So that was my last commercial for now, other than maybe a plug for ice cream. So stick around. We've got about maybe 3 or 4 minutes to warm up, and we'll be right back with Wind Ensemble. Thank you.
Thank you.
Please welcome to the stage, Mr. Henry Depew. Thank you. Thank you guys, I know it's been a long night. Maybe not ice cream tonight, it's up to you, but definitely ice cream this weekend because a job well done for all the band students. And one more round of applause for your for our symphonic, our cadet, our jazz. Please stand up, and rock. We are gonna turn the lights on and get these guys out of here in just about 5 minutes. We're gonna ask to clean up the stage. And if you wanna just stack your chairs in groups of six, that would be helpful to us. Thank you. Just chairs, groups of six, and have a nice night.